And we can do the same thing with what's called a vortex sheet. And that vortex sheet that we can put a series of vortices that are all right next to each other and vary in strength as you move along S again. And we can look at the differential segment caused by this sheet of vorticity. So again, if this is our differential segment S, and we're looking at some point P of XY, we have some radial vector from that point. And we also are going to have some theta direction, theta hat that is perpendicular to R. And so the differential velocity now from that small segment is equal to minus gamma. We use little gamma of S, where gamma is the strength of the sheet at that location, over 2 pi r, and that is in the theta hat direction, and multiplied by ds. So this would be the differential velocity caused by this differential segment of strength gamma. And again, we can integrate that over the sheet, and so the total induced velocity at that point would be equal to one or minus 1 over 2 pi. Again, that 2 pi is a constant, we can bring it out front. We integrate from 0 to the length of the sheet of gamma of s, the strength over r. That's just the distance away from that point, which is a function of s as well. And theta hat will also be changing as we move along s, and multiply that, or we're integrating in s, so we've got ds there. So again, same thing as the source sheet, but this is a vortex sheet, and now we can combine source sheets and vortex sheets as well as these other potential flow elements. And this is going to offer a lot of flexibility in the type of geometries that we can begin to model. One more thing to note about the vortex sheet is that there is a step change. If you were to sample a point just above and below that sheet, there's a step change in tangential velocity. Now, with the source sheet, it was a step change in normal velocity. But with the vortex sheet, it's a step change in tangential velocity. So if you were to look at the velocity that is tangential to the sheet just above and just below, we'd find a step change in that velocity. So just above, we might have a velocity going that direction, and just below, we'd have a velocity going that direction. And the difference between those two is equal to the strength of gamma at that location, or the strength of the sheet. And if you look at the normal velocity, there's actually no difference in normal velocity as you move across that sheet. Or I should say the normal velocity is continuous as you move across that sheet. So just above and just below, in the limit as those approach the location of that sheet, those will be equivalent.